Hey, what's up? I'm Jacob Kaufman, and I'm the Nerd on the Street, and today I am making another video in my, Minecraft series. Let's see if I can log in here. Minecraft servers were having some issues, earlier today, but it looks like we're good. I'll just spread my window out, and single player. Create new world. Today, I am, showing you how to survive your first night in Minecraft. So we are going to be in survival mode, because if you're in creative mode, you don't really have to worry about surviving, but, you know, all of this stuff is just normal. Create new world. How do you survive your first night in Minecraft? Now, if you've never played Minecraft before, it might be a little, scary, because you're like, you know, what am I supposed to do, right? I'm just going to show you, and I really shouldn't be wasting time adjusting my window size, because once you start, you have, like, 5 minutes, 5 minutes before, you basically run out of time. So here, I've spawned, Render distance isn't normal. Give me a minute. Max FPS, view bobbing off. Keep that on. Fast. There we go. Okay. So, how to survive your first night in Minecraft. So, here I just spawned. And I spawned on a beach. We're going to head in towards the forest, though. Now, as you'll see up there, we can press Control to zoom in. Oh, maybe not. Up there is the sun. You can see it slowly moving. And yes, it is moving. And we basically have until that sun goes down until mobs start spawning. Mobs are the monsters like zombies, creepers, and skeletons. They're called mobs. No idea why I just call them monsters, except they're called mobs in Minecraft. So we're going to head over here. You're going to want to build or dig yourself out a little house. You're going to want some food. You're going to want to make some torches, and I'll show you how to do that. So yeah, how to survive your first night. So over here is a pig, and we're going to... We're going to hit the pig. Wow. In recent updates of this game, the animals have really gotten harder to kill. So, basically, you just hit the pig until it dies, and then you'll get some pork. We are going to save that pork for when we are hungry. And now we're going to head over to the nearest trees. You can do this in whatever order you want, as long as you get it all done. And actually, if my client keeps sticking, then... But here we've got a tree here. You will notice there are different kinds of wood. There's this kind of wood, there's that kind of wood. Don't worry, all of the kinds of wood behave the same. You know, they just look different. This is birch wood. There's different kinds of wood. There's oak wood and, you know, all kinds of stuff, but... You don't have to worry about what kind of wood it is. So, to punch, maybe I should have started on a bit more of an elementary level. Clicking something like this, like hitting it once, is called punching. And you can click with your left mouse button one time to punch, and click and hold to mine out a block like that. When the block breaks, these lines go until they cover the entire thing. And when the block breaks, then you have mined it. And I'm sorry, this is going really slow. Let's turn full screen on, and... Okay, well, back to game. And so, yeah, we're here. You want to... I'm gonna turn that music down there. Alright, so we're going to dig ourselves out a little house, first of all. So you don't have to do this in any particular area. Me, I'm just going to dig into this small hill right here. Just going to dig into the side. You can dig down, you can dig wherever you want. You just, you need some sort of shelter. I think that's the video, the recording thing that keeps sticking. Alright, so as you'll see, some of these stone blocks, some of the blocks like stone, it takes longer to punch. That's why you need tools. So if you press E on your keyboard, this is your inventory right here. You'll see your person right there follows you around, your mouse around, and you have all of your stuff here. So I'm going to take my wood, right-click one time in each square. You just click on it to pick it up, right-click to place one, and that did not do anything. Oh, don't do that. Sorry. Let's do this again. Just right-click a couple of times, put like two in there. You'll have eight of these. Now we have birchwood planks. So if you just put four birchwood planks down, you get a crafting table, and they can be whatever kind of wood plank. It doesn't have to be birchwood. But you get a crafting table, and we can, to move your cursor or the thing that you're holding around, you scroll up or down. Scrolling up moves to the left, scrolling down moves to the right, and right click to place the block you're holding. Alright, so here we're going to put two wood planks on top of each other to get some sticks. And we're going to get some more wood planks. Now you'll see here, we have a 4x4 crafting thing. The reason you need a crafting table is because this is 3x3 instead of 2x2. That other one was not 4x4, it was 2x2. But now we have a 3x3 opening so we can craft more things. So we put two sticks down to make a basic axe, and then three wood planks at the top. We make a little T, and that will give us a wooden pickaxe. Now with this wooden pickaxe, you'll see a couple of things change. First of all, it becomes a lot quicker mining blocks. And secondly, you can pick up some blocks like stone. Before, I wasn't getting any stone when I was mining them because I wasn't using the right tool. But now, since I use the wooden pickaxe, I have some cobblestone. Where's the sun? We are running out of time. Alright, so you'll see here is some of this stuff. It looks kind of like stone. It's got some black stuff in it. That is called coal. Now, coal helps you make torches. Now, a lot of people think that you have to find coal your first day. That is not true. I'm also going to show you how to make charcoal out of wood in a furnace, and that is just as good as coal. Now, to make a furnace, you go on your crafting bench, and you take cobblestone, and you make a kind of like a circle. So now you have a furnace. So you can take that furnace, you can place it, and now you can put things in and take things out. So as you can see here, I have some coal. I can also put one wood on each. Wood is the bottom thing is your fuel. The top thing is what you're putting in the furnace to burn. Furnace is used for concentrating materials. But yeah, here now we have charcoal. Now, coal and charcoal cannot be mixed. They're two different materials, but they basically do the exact same thing for our purposes. So, now we want to make some torches because it's going to get dark, like I said. We go into our crafting bench to make a torch. You just put a stick, put either charcoal or coal. It can be either one. And now we have four torches. So we can put some torches down. Let's make our house a little bigger here. Alright, so let's put a torch right here. We can go out here. Now, there are lots of other tools you can make. For instance, here we go. We will make some more planks. Some other tools that you can make are a shovel, which is two sticks and one plank. You can make an axe, or no, that's a hoe, is that. And then if you add another wooden plank, then you get an axe. We're going to take the axe. So yeah, shovel, hoe, pickaxe, axe. Those are kind of the... Oh, and then there's a sword. That's one stick and two wooden planks. So this allows us to mine wood faster now that we have the axe. Okay. Now how do we... Let's get into some cosmetic things. Let's get some more wooden planks. And you'll see, I cannot combine these wooden planks into one stack because these are oak wood planks and these are birch wood planks. However, it's okay. We're going to build a door. A door is just six wood planks. We can intermix these. So it's alright. So, it doesn't matter what kind of wood planks they are. So now we have a wooden door. So now you can place a door down. And now our house has a door. You can right-click the door to use it. Left-click the door to mine it. But that's if you want to take it down. Now, So, what about some other things? Let's get just a little bit more wood here. These are just some day one things that you'll probably want to do. Now, always take the time to get as much wood as is in your sight, because it really, you can't go wrong with wood. You're always going to need wood for things. One of the things that you'll consistently need wood for is cooking meat. Now, as you can see, I'm not very hungry right now. In fact, I'm going to turn my game mode onto hard so that I'll get hungry faster. Down here, right here in the bottom right, those things that look kind of like turkey legs, that's food. And see this raw pork chop? Now I could eat that, but if I ate that, then it would give me a couple of those food points, and I have the chance of getting sick with some foods. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put raw pork chop in the furnace, put a couple of pieces of wood there. And what will we get? We will get cooked pork chop. Now, watch this. I'm going to exit the furnace. You can see it's still burning. It's still working. It's starting to get dark out outside. Now, when it gets dark out, you'll probably want to go inside. But yeah, as you can see, it really is. It's not the hardest thing in the world getting set up. You see, we have a nice little 3x3 house here just on day one. Some people like to take it slower. I've seen guides that basically you just dig down and make a little hole for yourself the first day because people don't think that you can do anything on day one. But you really can. You can get yourself established on day one. This looks pretty well established to me. We have a 3x3 house. We have a furnace and a crafting table. We've got all kinds of stuff. We've got food. I'm going to get my cooked pork chop. Now, as you can see, you know what? I'm not going to say anything else. We have a house with a door, and we've got... Well, I showed you how to craft basic things. The door is actually getting pretty complicated for day one, but we've got the torch. We've got coal. I showed you how to get wood and make different tools. So I am going to make more videos about how to enhance your house, how to enhance your tools, and how to do more things in Minecraft. But this was just a quick thing, how to survive your first day in Minecraft. If we go outside, you'll see there's a zombie over here. Now see, the zombie's going to come towards me. And it's going to hurt me. Now I'm going to run back frantically to my house. So yes, on day one, you probably want to stay inside. So now we got creepers outside, we got zombies outside, we got all kinds of mobs outside, but that's okay, because you're safe now in your small little house. You've got tools and supplies. So yes, once again, I'm Jacob Kaufman. I'm the Nerd on the Street. And that was how to survive... Whoa. That was how to survive your first day in Minecraft. Bye. I didn't know that could happen. Wow, the zombie actually broke down my door. Okay, in that case, you probably want to take a couple of wood planks and seal your door up like that. I did not know that zombies could break down doors like that. So now we're safe. Okay, so once again, I'm Jacob Kaufman. I'm the Nerd on the Street, and that was how to survive your first night in Minecraft. See ya.